Good afternoon, students. In previous lectures, we have discussed about the fuel, its classification, properties of ideal fuel, regarding the coal and its classification and its analysis. Today, we are going to discuss about the calorific value, its determination by bomb calorimeter, metallurgical coke, carbonization and manufacturing of metallurgical coke. First, we are starting with the calorific value. So, what is the meaning of calorific value? It is the amount of heat energy produced on complete combustion of unit mass or unit volume of the fuel. This is called calorific value. The calorific value of fuel is expressed in unit called kilojoule per kilogram, or if the fuel is liquid form or gaseous form, then we are using kilojoule per meter cube, or another units are kilocalorie per kilogram or kilocalorie per meter cube. The calorific value of some common fuels are, these are the fuels. The most important fuels used in our daily life is petrol, kerosene, diesel. The calorific value estimated is 45,000 kilojoule per kilogram. Do you know about CNG? It is a compressed natural gas. Its calorific value is higher than petrol. It is 50,000 kilojoule per kilogram. Do you also know the LPG, liquefied petroleum gas? Its calorific value is 55,000 kilojoule per kilogram. And hydrogen, its calorific value is highest among these all fuels. It is 150,000 kilojoule per kilogram. Calorific value may be classified into two categories. First is gross calorific value or a higher calorific value, and second one is net calorific value or lower calorific value. What is the meaning of gross calorific value? It is a total amount of heat energy produced on complete combustion of unit mass or unit volume of the fuel, and the products of combustion are cooled or condensed at room temperature. Means, in this calorific value, the amount of heat produced by the fuel as well as the heat of condensation or energy produced by the condensation is also included. Hence, it is called gross calorific value or higher calorific value. Net calorific value or lower calorific value. The total amount of heat energy produced on complete combustion of unit mass or unit volume of the fuel, and the products of combustion are allowed to escape. Means, there is no condensation process involved during the calculation of net calorific value. It is short abbreviated form is NCV or LCV. It is the relationship between LCV and HCV. LCV is equal to HCV minus latent heat of water vapor produced. Or may be used LCV is equal to HCV minus mass of hydrogen present in the fuel into 9 into latent heat of steam. In general, latent heat of steam is 587 kilocalorie per kilogram. For example, 0.5 kilogram of coal is completely burned, releases 5000 kilojoule energy, and the products of combustion are allowed to condense at room temperature. So, calculate the gross calorific value of coal. If coal sample contains 5% hydrogen, then also calculate the LCV. Given latent heat of steam is 580 kilojoule per kilogram. So, the given data are Q 5000 kilojoule and W 0.5 kilogram. Gross calorific value is given by Q divided by W. Putting these data, 5000 divided by 0.5, the value is 10,000 kilojoule per kilogram. Now, using this relationship, LCV is equal to HCV minus latent heat of water vapor produced, or LCV is equal to HCV minus mass of hydrogen. Here the mass is 5% into 9 into latent heat of steam. Since given latent heat of steam is 580 kilojoule per kilogram, according to data, the LCV is 9739 kilojoule per kilogram. Bomb calorimeter. In laboratory purpose, the calorific value of solid and liquid fuel is experimentally determined by bomb calorimeter. This is the block diagram of bomb calorimeter. In this calorimeter, there are basically three important parts. First part, this is the bomb. This is the made up of either copper or steel. This is bomb. This is basically a crucible. And in this crucible, the weight sample of given coal sample is taken. These are the magnesium wires which are connected to these platinum electrodes. This is the entry of oxygen through oxygen valve. Now, this complete bomb collimator is kept in the water jacket. This is the water and this is a thermometer using for the calculation of temperature of the water before burning of the fuel and after burning of the fuel. So it is called water jacket, and these both bomb collimator and water jacket are kept in the insulated chamber. This is the third and final insulated chamber. The fuel is burned by electric arc. So for providing the electric arc, these are the platinum electrodes. These are connected to the high voltage battery. Now, what is the principle of bomb collimator? A known amount of solid or liquid fuel here is burned under the influence of electric arc here and regular supply of oxygen. Due to combustion, heat is liberated. When fuel is burned, the heat will be liberated, which is absorbed by the water, and heat is transmitted towards water. So this heat is absorbed by the water. During the absorption of heat, the temperature of water increases. Then applying the principle of heat conservation, heat released by the fuel is equal to heat absorbed by the calorimeter, this is the calorimeter, and water. We can determine the calorific value of the fuel. For the basic working, a known amount of solid or liquid fuel is taken in crucible supported over rings. A piece of magnesium wire is tightly stretched across the electrodes touching the fuel sample. The bomb is filled with oxygen at about 25 to 30 atm pressure and the lid is tightly screwed. The bomb is placed inside the copper calorimeter in which known amount of water is already filled. After thorough stirring, initial temperature of water is noted, say T1. Now electrodes are connected to high voltage battery and circuit is completed. The fuel sample is burned and heat is produced, which gets transferred to water, which is steered throughout the experiment with electric steer. Final temperature of water is recorded. These are the observation table. Weight of fuel x gram, weight of water capital W gram, water equivalent of calorimeter, it is small W gram. Initial temperature of water T1 degree Celsius, final temperature of water T2 degree Celsius, and the HCV say L calorie per gram. What are the basic calculations involved? Heat liberated by the fuel, it is X into L calorie. Heat absorbed by water, this is W, T2 minus T1, since the specific heat of water becomes 1. Heat gained by calorimeter, it is W, T2 minus T1 calorie. According to the heat conservation, heat liberated by the fuel, this is XL, heat absorbed by water and calorimeter, it should be sum of these two values, W plus W, T2 minus T1. Hence, HCV is given by W plus W, T2 minus T1 divided by X. But there are some corrections during the bomb calorimeter, calculation of bomb calorimeter. Fuse wire correction. The fused magnesium wire is used to ignite the fuel. The heat liberated by burning of fuse wire is also added in HCV as measured in above manner. Hence, this amount of heat should be subtracted. Acid correction. If sulfur and nitrogen present in fuel, these are oxidized into sulfuric acid and nitric acid respectively. Since the formation of these acids is exothermic, hence this heat should be subtracted because the presence of these elements in fuel is undesirable. And third one is cooling correction. Since in bomb collimator the reactions occur in closed vessel, hence condensation of gaseous products taken place simultaneously. Hence cooling correction must be added to measure the actual rise in temperature. When all these corrections are included, then the corrected formula for the calculation of HCV by bomb collimator is given by W plus W, T2 minus T1 plus cooling correction. These data should be subtracted, acid correction, fuse wire correction, divided by weight of fuel. And after that, LCV is calculated by the given formula. Suppose we take an example for this explanation. A sample of coal contains carbon 93%, hydrogen 6%, and ash. The following data were obtained when the coal was tested in bomb collimator. The weight of coal is 0.95 gram, weight of water taken 2000 gram, water equivalent of bomb kilometer 700 gram, rise in temperature 2.48 degree Celsius, fuse wire correction 10 calorie, acid correction 60 calorie, and cooling correction is 0.02 degree Celsius. Calculate the HCV and LCV of the coal given the latent heat of condensation of steam is 587 calorie per gram. We have to use this formula, putting the above data, HCV, and the value will be 7031.6 calorie per gram. After we are using this formula, LCV is equal to HCV minus mass of hydrogen. Here the mass of hydrogen is 6%, so we are using the 6 by 100 into 9 into latent heat, which should be 587 in this numerical. The value will be 6767.45 calorie per gram. Now we are going far further and starting regarding the metallurgical coke. When coal is heated at high temperature, in the absence of air, volatile matter gets driven off and the white, lustrous, porous, dense, strong and coherent mass which is left is known as coke. The process of conversion of coal into coke is called carbonization. It must be noted that all type of coals cannot be converted into coke. Parent coal can be classified in the following categories depending on the behavior of coal when it is heated in the absence of air. First one is caking coal. Caking coal is the coal which have the tendency to become soft, plastic and fused together to form a solid, porous, coherent mass on heating at high temperature. The residue left is known as coke, but this coke is not useful for metallurgical purpose. Coking coal. If the coke is hard, porous and strong, then the parent coal from which it is formed, then the coal is called coking coal. This coke is suitable for metallurgical purpose. These are the main features of carbonization. Carbonization is taking place by two methods, low temperature carbonization and high temperature carbonization. First, heating temperature. In low temperature, 500 to 700 degrees Celsius. Here, 1000 to 1200 degrees Celsius. Volatile matter is 15% in coke. Here, 1 to 3% in coke. Mechanical strength of coke, mechanically not very strong. Here, the coke will be mechanically strong. Yield of coke. Yield of coke here is higher, 75 to 80%, while here something lower, 65 to 70%. Hardness of coke, here the coke is soft and here coke is hard. Calorific value of gases. Here calorific value is higher, 6500 to 9500 kilocalorie per meter cube. Here slight, while here calorific value is slightly lower. This is 5500 to 6000 kilocalorie per meter cube. The percentage aromatic hydrocarbon in evolved gases, here is lower, here higher. Percentage of straight chain hydrocarbon, here higher, here lower. Smoke produced on burning, here the smoke is, here the coke is smokeless, while here the coke is smoky. Use of coke, here coke is used for domestic purpose, while here coke used for the metallurgical purpose. You have to focus in these three important points in high temperature carbonization. First, why it is called high temperature? Because the temperature is higher than low temperature, 1000 to 1200 degrees Celsius. Second, the hardness of coke, it should be very hard. And finally, the coke is used for industrial or metallurgical purpose. Now, what is the method or manufacturing of metallurgical coke? In industries, there are two important methods. First is Beehive oven method and second is Otto Hoffman byproduct oven method. Beehive coke oven method is a classical method, while Otto Hoffman byproduct oven method is the modern method. And presently in industries, this method is frequently used for the manufacturing of metallurgical coke. So we have to discuss only here Otto Hoffman byproduct oven method. In order to increase the thermal efficiency of carbonization process and to recover the valuable byproducts, Otto Hoffman developed a modern byproduct oven. It consisting of number of narrow silica chambers. It is a picture of Otto Hoffman byproduct oven process. Here we will see narrow silica chambers. These are the silica chambers and these chambers are loaded with the coal. It is the exit of waste gases. This is the air and producer gas, which is used as a fuel for the burning of coal, and it is an important feature of this oven. These are the recovery chambers, where the hot coke oven gases are passed in various chambers where these various important products are recovered. So it consists of number of narrow silica chambers. Each chamber is provided with a charging hole at top, a gas offtake and refractory line cast iron door at each end for discharging coke. Coal is introduced into the chambers and the chambers are closed. The ovens are heated to 1200 degrees Celsius by burning a gaseous fuel. We are using the producer gas for the fuel and usually employ a regenerative principle to active economical heating. Regenerative principle means the heat of these gases is used for burning of the coal, which are kept in the another chambers. The fuel gases produced during combustion are passed to the regenerator's checker brick work that takes up the heat and gets heated to about 1000 degrees Celsius. The flow of heating gases is the reverse, so that the hot flue gases preheat the other chambers. The heating is continued till the evolution of volatile matter ceases completely, which is about 11 to 18 hours. When coke is formed, a massive raw pushes the red hot coke outside. It is subsequently quenched by water spray. The coke obtained by dry quenching in dryer clean and stronger than wet quenched coke. This is the auto-offering byproduct oven process. We have already discussed about this. Now, one of the important key feature of this oven is recovery of byproducts. The gas coming out here, the coke oven gas is coming out and supply into the recovery chambers. The gas coming out from the oven is called coke oven gas and is composed of ammonia, H2S, naphthalene, tar, benzene, etc. This can be separated from each other. Coal tar. The coke oven gas is passed through a tower where liquor ammonia is sprayed from the top. Dust and tar gets collected in tank, which is heated by steam coils to recover ammonia back. Ammonia. Now the gas is passed through a tower where water is sprayed. Ammonia goes into a solution forming the ammonium hydroxide. Naphthalene. Now the gas is then passed to a cooling tower where water is sprayed at a very low temperature. Condensation of some gases takes place and naphthalene is recovered. Benzene. The gas is then sprayed with petroleum, hence benzene and its homologous are recovered. Removal of hydrogen sulfide. The gas is now passed through a purifier filled with iron oxide. Iron oxide reacts with H2S and gives iron sulfide. After all the iron oxide is exhausted, the purifier is exposed to atmospheric air when Fe2O3 is regenerated and leaving sulfur dioxide gas. These are the chemical reactions. In this manner, the byproducts will be recovered and also the yield of coke is much better than any other known process for industries.